Let's talk about verbal behavior and two very important defining features, point-to-point correspondence and formal similarity. This concerns only four of the six elementary verbal operants: textual, transcription, echoic, and intraverbal. Point-to-point correspondence and formal similarity do not concern the mand and the tact. Do you want to know why? Well, it has to do with the controlling stimulus. The mand is controlled by an MO and the tact is controlled by a nonverbal SD. And point-to-point correspondence and formal similarity are relevant to the verbal operants that are controlled by a verbal SD. Textual, transcription, and echoic, also intraverbal, are controlled by verbal SDs. Now, with formal similarity, I want you to think form of behavior, sense mode, spoken, written, signed, and so on. So when a verbal behavior is the exact same form as the stimulus that controls it, we've got formal similarity. We always have formal similarity with echoic behavior. An echoic is a spoken response that is controlled or evoked by an identical spoken response. The antecedent is spoken and the verbal behavior is spoken. Intraverbal behavior may or may not have formal similarity. Like if I ask a question vocally and you answer me vocally, well then yes, your verbal behavior has formal similarity with the antecedent that controls it. But what if the question is spoken and the response is written? If a written intraverbal behavior is in response to a vocal antecedent, well, then there is no formal similarity. The antecedent and the behavior, they have to be in the same sense mode, either both spoken, written, signed, and so on. Textual and transcription will never have formal similarity. So now on to point-to-point correspondence, which only presents in echoic, textual, and transcription behavior. And what that means is the content of the antecedent is exactly the same as the content of the verbal response. Like in echoic behavior, let's say the antecedent is, hey, what's up? Well, the echoic response must also be, hey, what's up? Hey, what's up has point-to-point correspondence with hey, what's up. Intraverbal should never have point-to-point correspondence. A defining feature of the intraverbal behavior is that there is no point-to-point correspondence with the controlling stimulus. So if the antecedent is, hey, what's up, the intraverbal response has to be something like, you know, something different, like not much, you know, what's new with you? So the takeaway, formal similarity, the antecedent and the behavior are the same sense mode, both spoken, written, signed, whatever. Point-to-point correspondence, the antecedent and the verbal behavior are the exact same content, not necessarily the same sense mode, but exactly the same content from start point to end point, point to point. I hope that helps.